Hey everybody, it is Brad.
And Krista.
With the Big Family Homestead, and it is party time!
Yes, it is. Today is New Year's Eve, and we're having some folks over this evening to hang out and have a little bit of fun. Definitely not staying up till past midnight, because
we're crusty old
people. I think
we're
getting old, too old for that.
We're crusty old people.
Yeah, definitely. So, yeah, we're going to make some party dips.
Yes.
Some yummy deliciousness.
And, well, let me tell you what, the inner chubby guy right here, inside, what are you doing, Mom?
I was making sure it was live. Unlike last time, it was not live.
I can see it was live, yeah, but it's okay. Yeah, three dips, two of which are very, very unique. One is pretty standard, but she has a really, really great recipe. The standard one's Pico de Gallo.
Yep.
But then the other two, drum roll please, Texas cheese roll.
Yes.
And a Reuben dip.
Yes. These are so yummy. The Reuben dip is actually one of my favorites. And I can tell you this, I'm not a huge fan of sauerkraut, but
it's perfect.
It's perfect. You don't really taste the sauerkraut. It's more for texture. No, I'm kidding.
It's probably so you can just call it a Reuben.
Yeah. No, there is enough sauerkraut in there to have that little bit of tang and flavor, but
Well, so where are you going to start?
I'm going to start, okay, so with a Reuben, your traditional Reuben is corned beef, sauerkraut, and
Thousand Island.
Well, I'm going to start actually with the Thousand Island dressing. I'm not going to use the bottled stuff. I have a recipe that is
stellar.
Perfect for this.
And so, I actually have a screen with the recipe on it.
Woohoo!
But I'm not sure if I got the right one first, because I didn't know which one you were going to start with.
Okay, well, I'm going to start with, and I didn't get all of my...
Let me see if I got the right screen.
Measuring devices or anything like
that. Look at the balloons. So, nope, Texas cheese roll. I got to go to the Reuben dip. Yes,
there
we go.
We're going to just have to guess on measurements, so...
What are we doing here?
We need 1 cup of mayonnaise.
Oh, you're making the Thousand Island first.
I'm making the Thousand Island dressing. Yeah, because you have to have the Thousand Island to go into the Reuben dip.
Yahtzee.
Yes.
Yahtzee. Hello to Savannah from the San Diego Mountains, Scott M., and Mary Wainick. Hey, y'all. She's from Georgia.
Oh, hey, y'all.
Hey, y'all. You're using your Thrive onions?
I am using Thrive onions because I hate chopping onions.
Well, and if you guys don't know, the Thrive Life onions are freeze-dried. And they're
so good.
They're really nice. Mm-hmm. You don't have to cut them. You just kind of scoop them and put them in. And they stay fresh right on your shelf.
Yep. So we need a third of a cup of onion. And I am using the Thrive onions.
Oh, close
cam.
You can
see there
you go.
Here.
Nice.
See that? They're perfect. I don't have to chop anything.
No chopping, no hopping, no fuss, no muss.
Nope, no muss. All right. Now we need garlic. Of course we need garlic.
Gotta have garlic.
God, it's, you know, I'm not sure if I'm happy with the half a teaspoon of garlic.
I don't think I'm liking that.
You know, that.
That's a half
that
teaspoon.
That ought to do. No.
That's a half teaspoon.
Okay. There you go.
It's very
more like a tablespoon. I love garlic.
Hit me, baby.
All right, we need ketchup.
How much?
3 tablespoons of ketchup, and I'm just going to eyeball it.
2, 3. There you go.
Because I didn't grab all of my measuring devices. So now we need also 3, where's my relish? Here we go. 3 tablespoons of pickle relish. And you can use sweet or dill. We're using dill.
Scott is kind of requesting that you skip the sour cabbage. You don't taste it that much, bro.
No, you really don't.
It's there and it adds a little zip, a little something.
Yeah.
But it's not like... You're just sitting there eating sauerkraut.
No. It just gives a little bit of texture. A couple of tablespoons of lemon juice or white vinegar. I had lemon juice handy. And now we need a half a teaspoon of, I'm using a lot of spoons. I should probably put the measuring devices right here.
That's a good idea. Or on the side.
Yeah.
On the side.
Half a teaspoon of paprika.
Hey there, Dan Schneider. Hello, Hedgehogs Homestead. Hey, where are you guys all from? You don't have to, if you don't want to divulge a secret location, you can just say, I'm from central Wisconsin or central blah, blah, blah. Where are you from? All right.
Yummy. Look at that.
She's in her apron.
Hi, Kimmy.
This recipe looks so good. Oh, yeah, the Reuben dip is silly.
Oh, my. Silly and silly easy.
Silly, silly, silly.
All right, there is the Thousand Island. Some nice texture with it. It's not super runny like a lot of Thousand Island dressings are. I don't like that.
Yeah.
I like some texture.
Tuna Shaver, hello. Dooley's Michigan is from Dooley's Michigan.
No way. No way. They're from Dooley's Michigan.
Yeah.
Just teasing.
Dooley's of Michigan.
Yes, I got it. I was just being silly. Okay. Now, I do have to show you something that I got at Cloverdale, though.
Do show. Oh, where are we going? Close cam?
No, I'm going to hold it up.
You're going to hold it up?
Okay. So, growing up, my mom always had those glass cutting boards, and I never really thought about them. And then when Jonathan and our families went to Cloverdale.
Which is an Amish.
Which is a Mennonite store.
Mennonite store, sorry.
In Curtis, we went there, and they had these glass cutting boards. Yeah. Look at this.
It says Grandma's Kitchen, and then I can't read it.
Meals and Memories Made Fresh Daily.
There you go.
I couldn't resist. And, you know, you'd think these were like $20, $30. No, $12.50. I couldn't believe it.
To be honest, it kind of creeps me out cutting on glass.
No, it's not. It's not bad. It's not bad at all.
Don't like it.
Okay. Okay.
I am entitled to my opinion.
You are entitled to your opinion. And I'm going to give it to you.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
You'll accept my opinion.
Right. Okay. Next, this is actually going faster than I thought.
Is this one you want? You got to bake?
This is one I have to bake.
Turn on the oven.
I was going to turn on the oven, but I have to move the tomatoes first.
I will move your maters, baby.
Your maters.
Your maters.
Because that gets hot back there.
That gets hot there. Yeah. How hot?
350.
Okay.
Here, I'm just going to turn it this way.
Whoops. Okay. There you go. Go ahead. Do your thing.
Okay. Okay. So the first thing I'm going to do is we need a cup of sauerkraut, but you have to squeeze out the juice. So I'm going to do that in a separate bowl.
Press it.
Yeah.
How do you plan another spoon? On doing it?
I have a strainer.
Gotcha.
So I'm going to scoop in a cup of sauerkraut here. That's probably a cup. Probably not. Probably more than that. And just kind of squeeze it. Oh, boy.
Ooh.
No, it's just my thumb.
Oh.
It's okay. It's okay.
It's okay.
It's okay. And then Hope can have the rest of the sauerkraut for lunch.
I love sauerkraut. Oh, my gracious.
He will eat it right out of the can.
I know. It's kind of gross. Yeah. I'll be honest. But you want to talk about a diet food?
Sauerkraut
is it. Mm-hmm. It's negative. Calorie negative.
Yeah.
You actually burn more calories eating it.
All right. So, and the reason for doing this is so that your dip is not super liquidy.
How much of that do you need again?
A cup.
So it looks like you're just about there.
Yeah. I think I need a little bit more, but it's okay. I'll get a little bit more.
That's pretty much a cup, but.
How much is in this?
I don't know.
Oh, you know what? I'm just going to use it all.
Uh-oh.
It's 14 ounces. It's not that big of a deal. And that goes with the weight of the water that's in it, too.
How big is a cup?
8 ounces.
That's kind of more than in a cup, then.
By weight, I'm going by volume.
I'm teasing you.
And a little bit extra sauerkraut is not going to hurt us.
Besides, it grows hairs on your chest.
That's right. That's what I've been told.
Yeah. Chest hairs.
That's why I won't eat it. I don't want hairs on my chest. I don't love it.
You love it.
No, I don't love it.
You love this dip.
I love this dip. It's because I can't taste the sauerkraut.
So.
There.
Dan Schneider. I live really close to some YouTubers. Yes, he does.
He does.
He does.
He does.
I'm going to have to buy some more honey soon, man. What you got for me? He's a beekeeper. Karen Bowers, hi, from Northern California. Tammy is in Seattle.
Oh, my goodness.
Let's see. All over the place.
Wasn't it Northern California that just got 9 feet of snow?
It was crazy.
Oh, my gosh.
Big.
Yeah. So
Old
crazy.
Old Glory Farm. It is Reuben Dip.
It is.
The first one. Here, I'll put up my crazy graphic.
It is
graphic.
Reuben Dip. Okay. So we got the sauerkraut squeezed out. Now we need the corned beef. And I just bought the cheap stuff that you get at the store in the awesome little packages. But it's actually, well, at our store, it wasn't cheap.
Yeah, nothing's cheap around here.
No.
When it comes to groceries.
No.
Yeah. Kind of getting worse, too.
Yeah.
So what happens next? You just cut it up?
Just going to cut it up.
Small
chop it
pieces?
Up. Mm-hmm.
All right. That gives me time to go to this screen so that you can see all of it.
Yep. Yep, super easy. Except the fact that I can't find the corners of this corn leaf.
Oh, no.
There we go. Got out of the way.
Cimarron Pass Homestead. Hey, thank you. Happy New Year to you as well.
Yeah. All right. We're just going to slice this like this, and then I'll chop it the other way so they're smaller pieces.
I got to make sure that's not poisoned.
Okay.
Just a little. Just no a little. Poison.
Oh, you dropped it on my slipper.
I'll get it. I didn't see nothing. Ooh, that's yummy.
Silly goose.
I love corned beef.
Yeah. Mm-mm-mm.
Man, corned beef and cabbage. That is one so of those good meals that can eat your body weight in it. And you're just like, oh, bring it on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. There's that.
Wow.
So is anyone having family or friends over for New Year's? Or does anybody stay in? Does anybody go out? What does everybody do?
What do you guys do?
Yeah. Because for years, when Brad was traveling with the band, we didn't go or do anything because he was always gone.
Yep, always
rocking out. He disappeared. Where'd he go?
I'm going to put the camera more on you because I think you look far better than
looking
at me.
Oh, my goodness gracious. There's that. It's probably more than we need, but okay, that's all right.
That's better. That's a better shot.
As I walk out of the camera.
Right here, halvesies.
As I walk out of the shot.
That's fine. Don't need to see a bunch of me.
All right. Now, so we've got the corned beef, the sauerkraut. Now we need our cream cheese.
Yeah. You know what? I'll actually
back it's over here. I don't know why I put it over there.
I don't know why.
Because I need two things of cream cheese, one for this recipe and one for the other recipe.
That might do it. Let's see.
Goodness gracious.
Live camera TV action.
My goodness.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to have to cheat it.
There you are.
Again.
That works.
Okay. Now. All right.
Tanya says she stays home with her 14-year-old. Haven't gone anywhere in years. Yeah, we don't go out.
No, we really don't.
Yeah, it's... Even if we did, we don't like that kind of atmosphere. We're just not into that.
No, no, we're not at all.
Yeah.
Okay, then we're going to go ahead and put in our Thousand Island dressing. We need about a half a cup. That looks like about a half a cup.
Looks good to me.
Maybe, maybe not. Not sure.
Mary says our small church group gathering tonight for games, food, and fellowship.
Cool. That's awesome.
Be safe when you're driving, though.
Yeah, no kidding.
Be safe when you're driving.
We need the Swiss cheese.
Shredded up.
Shredded.
Yeah.
But we need to save a little bit of the Swiss cheese. This was a 7-ounce block that we shredded. And you need to save some for the top. Hey.
What?
We had just barely enough. Right. You goof.
That's yummy.
Yeah.
And Swiss cheese. Excuse me. Mama doesn't care for Swiss cheese unless it's on something like a recipe.
Yeah. I don't like it by itself.
No. Oh, man. That's so good, though.
This spoon is awful.
What's Sam?
Probably because it's not a spoon, it's a spatula.
Faith and Family says we stay home and play games, watch good movies.
That's awesome. It's honestly, it's safer to be at home.
Yeah. Well, and I don't like staying up late anyway, believe it or not.
No. Like we said, we're a little old, so.
So here's a fun thing that we've done in the past. So if you've got some folks over, maybe there's four or five of you. One thing that we've done that was a big hit is you tell people, okay, I want you to go to your DVD collection or wherever you watch movies, and you say, you're going to pick out two of your favorite scenes ever in the movies. One could be like a comedy, and then the other could be a drama, and then everybody gets to play their 5 or 10 minute scene, and it really actually is cool because it sheds light on the personalities of people even more than you thought.
Oh, yeah.
Because they'll say, well, I like this scene because blah. Mm-hmm. And then you watch it, and it's like a connection. It's almost like the mixtapes that we used to make a long time ago with cassettes, where you'd invest yourself. Ooh, I'm flinging
sauce. Don't do that.
You'd invest yourself into somebody else by sharing those emotions. Mm-hmm. So something different.
All right.
Is the Reuben dip in y'all's cookbook?
It is not. I'm sad to say it is not.
This recipe
was given to us by a friend of ours. She brought the dip for one of our Saturday night gatherings, and I said, I have to have that recipe.
Whose first name?
Alyssa.
Oh, yeah, it was good.
Yes.
Yes.
It's Alyssa gave me this recipe, and oh, my goodness.
The other two are in the cookbooks.
The other
two
are.
This one you'll have to just write down.
Yep.
Just pause the video and copy it.
Yep. I hope this fits in here.
Oh, mash it in.
Yep.
It'll go. Ooh, that looks so good, Mom. Mm-hmm. And the Reuben dip, too.
Oh, come on now.
No, oh, come on now. It's New Year's. All right.
I did add a little bit more Thousand Island dressing because it seemed a little dry, which I know the cream cheese will melt and the cheese will melt. And
oh, you got to mash it in there,
yeah,
baby.
Yeah.
Smash it down.
Yeah, so.
Karen says, I usually don't make it till midnight. I get up at 5 to feed my horses and clean the stalls. Yeah. They don't care what holiday is. Isn't that the truth?
That is so true.
We're milking the cows for us, feeding the cat, doing the...
Right. Yeah, taking care of the chickens, making sure that they're, you know, they
feeding
got enough
the
food.
Other animals that have two legs and run around and want to eat.
Man, do they want to eat
Can you
again?
Believe that they want to eat 3 times a day? Can you believe that?
Insane. All right, I'm going to top this with cheese.
All right.
And this is going to bake for about 20, 25 minutes.
Yeah.
Just needs to get
happy,
melty,
happy,
and
happy
warm, one. And delicious. This bowl is probably not the right size. I should have probably used a bigger bowl. You know
That's
what?
Okay.
Oh well.
What we'll do is we'll stick a spoon there, so instead of people like dipping into it, they can scoop a spoon out and put it on their plate.
Right.
That'll work.
All right, sweetie.
Get out of the way.
I don't want you to get burned.
Get out of the way.
I'm gonna put this on a cookie sheet.
That is good thinking, Mom. Thinking ahead.
I don't want it to, it'll be hard to get out of there when it's hot, so.
Yeah. All
and
right, question, guys.
Expand.
What would you view as a New Year's movie? What would be a movie you would say, hey, this is a movie you should watch on New Year's, or one that would be appropriate?
Yeah.
Curious. What would I think? What would you think?
I have no idea. I'm not good at remembering what, you know, some movies.
And again, sorry, how long?
20, 25 minutes.
Yeah.
I'm gonna put it in for 20.
20.
There we go.
Wait till you see it when it's done.
Oh, it's so good.
Let me get this out of your way. So.
Oh, goodness.
A New Year's movie, huh? What would they come up with?
I don't know.
I would say It's a Wonderful Life. But everybody associates that with Christmas.
Yeah.
Let's see, what else? You know, those second chance kind of movies. Maybe, oh, there's a kitty.
Yeah.
She's hunting. She's outside in the snow hunting.
Silly kitty.
Maybe, you know, it would be a good one would be Pay It Forward.
Pay It Forward is a good one.
That movie is not necessarily for small kids.
No.
But, because there's some graphic images in there.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a good movie about paying it forward.
Yeah. All right.
Scott says Willy Wonka. I love it. Yes.
Oh, that's a great movie.
We are the music makers.
We are
the dreamers of dreams.
Okay.
That's right.
Committing
Where'd you go?
Cardinal sin of
Where'd you go?
Microwaving the cream cheese. But it got put in the freezer. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's that.
Yeah.
Which one are you making now?
I'm making the Texas cheese dip.
Okay, so I'm going to go back to that recipe. Let's go up here. That way you guys can grab that one. It's a Texas cheese roll. This
Texas
one is
cheese
in
roll.
The...
Which this one is cookbook? In Home Essentials. Home? Big Family Essentials.
Well, and let them know that it is on sale till the end of the day.
All of our cookbooks are on sale right now. They were about 25% off. And... today is the last day. So tonight, at midnight, whenever I change the price, it'll probably be in the morning. But The sale would be different. Where did you go?
I had to get a cracker.
He just took off. He just left me.
I gotta get a cracker because that Reuben dip is, or the Reuben stuff you made.
Right.
I just tasted it.
Right.
And it's really, really good. I'm like, I want a cracker.
My goodness.
So, I got a cracker.
And I know you're probably not, I know you're not supposed to put, Sound of Music is a good one.
That is a good one.
You're not supposed to put cream cheese in the freezer. Somehow it got put in the freezer. No idea what happened.
Sleepless in Seattle. That's funny.
Oh, because they meet at the top of the Eiffel Tower, Empire State Building on New Year's. Right.
Gene.
No, it was not New Year's. It was Valentine's Day.
There you go.
And I know this because I watched it recently.
Gene says Princess Bride. Good movie.
It's an excellent movie.
Good movie.
All right.
My gracious.
This is a very cheesy dip.
Yeah, but this is the kind of stuff that you don't have it all the time.
No, of course not. Quit eating the Thousand Island.
I can't help it. It's good. And besides, that cracker broke off in it, so I can't leave that in there.
Oh, man.
Can't leave that in there.
That's crazy.
Good call on the Wizard of Oz. Yep.
Yep. Wizard of Oz is good. All righty.
Hey, thank you, Stuart.
Cream cheese.
We do appreciate the likes.
Cheddar cheese. Garlic. Pecans. I have to make sure I have everything. Chili powder. Paprika.
Riyadh says, I can't even boil water.
Sure you can. You put water in a pot and you put it on the stove and turn it on.
There you go.
It'll boil. Turn it on high.
You should watch that, who's the cooking lady? Julia Child's movie. Oh, goodness.
Yeah.
I cut the dickens out of myself.
That's Saturday Night Live, not the actual movie.
That skit was really funny.
Oh my goodness.
So where are we at, babe?
Okay. So I got everything, hopefully, for this recipe. that's hot.
Cream cheese?
8 ounces of cream cheese.
In you go.
In you go. And
I'll
I am going to use a hand mixer. Where are you going?
Another cracker.
Oh. He keeps leaving the set. You're not supposed to eat on.
You can talk.
Okay.
Chat
now
it
we
up,
need
sister.
1 pound. Oh, bummer. Do we have any more cheddar cheese?
The white cheddar.
Yeah, I'm going to have to use that because.
Yeah, we just got that at the Mennonite.
Because
store.
It says 1 pound of cheese, I got 8 ounces.
That's
I
not enough.
Thought the recipe said 1 cup of cheddar cheese. That's not enough. Whoops, as I fling cheese.
Yeah, there's some right there.
Yeah. I will get the cheese out of the freezer or fridge that we just bought.
Lady Jean, why can't you freeze cream cheese?
I don't know. On the metal package, on the metal wrapper, it says keep refrigerated.
Yeah.
And it does mess with the texture when you freeze it.
It does. It gets weird.
Yeah, it gets weird. So.
Oh, my gracious. I could straight up just eat that Reuben sauce, whatever that
Thousand
is.
Thousand Island.
So good.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know another one of the dips that she makes? I guess you could call it a dip. But it is so good, is just her plain old tartar sauce.
Oh,
She's got
really
a knockoff of the Frisch's Big Boy tartar sauce.
Yeah, it's really good.
And it's silly good. Yeah. Makes you want to eat more fish.
Plate. Yeah, and we do because of it.
Hey, Delaney B. Hey, Steve. Hey, Felicia. Yes, these are all calorie-free. Absolutely.
Absolutely calorie-free.
Okay. Let's see.
So this is a white cheddar that we got from the Cloverdale store, and it was really reasonable.
And it's super creamy.
Super
Did
creamy.
You taste it?
Not yet today.
You should. Brad, you're sounding like you're feeling better. I'm on the tail end of just a regular old cold, guys.
Yeah.
Krista got it too, but she got over fast.
Yeah.
And
It usually takes Brad a little bit longer to get over something.
I've got some weird autoimmune thing with my back, and I think it does mess with me. I don't know why. But I'm trying to get a little bit better so I can continue singing. I've got these scripture projects that are songs.
Yeah.
And I've got two that are ready to go, but I need some voice first. Mm-hmm.
That cheese is super creamy.
So why don't you come over and sing it there, Steve? I know he plays bass guitar.
All right. Another 1/2 pound cheese in there.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So I'm going to try really hard to follow the recipe.
You can do it.
I can. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Gives me strength.
Yeah. Okay. Now, so we've got cream cheese and a pound of cheese. So I apologize for the small hiccup. Now we need garlic, and yes, lots and lots of garlic.
And if you don't like garlic, just back off the recipe.
Yeah, you don't have, you know what? That's the thing. Recipes are not meant to be followed exactly.
Yeah, exactly. Tailor them to what you like.
Right, exactly. So I think that's all my garlic left in the jar.
We go through a lot of garlic.
We do.
Vampires are not coming to our house.
No. We go through more garlic than is humanly possible. We can't grow enough garlic for what we use.
No.
No. All right, chili powder. It's a tablespoon of chili powder, and that is all that's left in my container because we ran out.
We eat a lot of chili powder.
We eat a lot of chili powder. A teaspoon of paprika.
Sandy is eating salmon with rub on it and sweet potato fries, bread, and a loaded salad.
Yum.
Sounds like you got a good plan there, sister.
Yeah. All right, teaspoon of salt. That's
not, there we go. Now, if you're wondering, too, we don't use the regular table salt.
No.
We use the pink Himalayan.
Right, we use the Himalayan salt. Now, the recipe calls for hot sauce. Frank's is
the choice.
The choice, but we don't have any Frank's. We have Berman's, which is an Aldi brand. It's a copy. So this is, it's almost there. It's almost identical.
Now,
and it's one tablespoon.
You're almost there.
There we go.
There you go. Now, how many of you guys believe this to be true? Because I do. Different hot sauces for different kinds of food make a big difference. Because I don't think there's a one-size-fits-all when it comes to hot sauce.
No.
Like, when we're having, like, tacos, it's Cholula.
Yeah.
You know, the one with the little wooden top? Cholula's got to be it. Matter of fact, if we ever go out to eat, we don't really stick around if they don't have it on the table because there's only Mexican restaurant. Mm-hmm. And if they don't have it, their food's kind of bland.
Yeah.
But there's other ones.
We need to keep it in the car.
Yeah. Yeah, but I believe there's a hot sauce for every use.
Yeah. Does hot sauce freeze?
Yeah, it's mostly vinegar.
No. Oh.
Vinegar, water, some tomatoes. Okay. It depends.
All right, I got to run this. So it's going to be loud for a second.
All right, Gene. Praise God. He turned the corner on COVID today.
Nice.
First days felt good. That's awesome, man.
Okay. Now,
Scott, I don't know. You know what? Email me, bro, because I need to know more about what you're asking. He's asking a question about Moringa.
Oh.
Because he knows that we're big time fans.
Yeah.
But what I can do is I can ask the guy who owns the company if he knows something.
Yeah.
Chalupa and eggs, yes.
Ooh.
Yes.
Chalupa or Cholula?
She says chalupa and eggs. That sounds good. Yeah. I can, Steve, I'll just ask him. His name's Alex. He's a good guy. And he's really super happy to help. So.
Alrighty. Now this next part's a little tricky.
What you got?
Well, you have to put this in plastic wrap.
Yes, ma'am.
And then roll it in pecans. So you have to wrap it so that it becomes a log.
Ooh, here, yeah, that looks awesome.
Yeah.
I'm gonna try to get to this camera. See if that, no, wrong camera. You just left. So yeah, there you go. Thank you.
Yeah.
So you're gonna plop it in there.
I'm gonna plop it in here and do my best to make it a log.
Uh-oh, the arrow's in the way. Let me get rid of the arrow, bang. There we go.
Save all that goodness there.
Oh my gosh, can't I want to bite it.
Here. There you go.
Oh, my friends. Oh, my party people. Oh, gosh, that's good.
Oh, good.
You rock, okay. Mom.
Well.
Oh, yeah.
I try.
Oh, yeah.
Alrighty. Now, this is the tricky part. I'm just going to use my hands because this is messy. This has always been difficult for me. I have always hated putting stuff
in a log.
Making a log.
I'm going to hold it still. You want me to give it a go?
No, I'm good. I got it now. Sort of. I just need to make it thinner.
That is one giant looking thing.
That is. Oh, I should have used wax paper or parchment paper or something.
Holy mackerel. It looks like some kind of villain you'd see in Star Trek. If it didn't taste so good, people, I would definitely be questioning.
Well, good news is it's going to be covered in pecans here in a second, so it doesn't matter.
I keep thinking of that scene in Christmas Vacation where Chevy Chase is talking to that woman, and he says he's got a log. Not, I don't have
don't,
like
no,
a
no,
Yule
no,
log.
No, no, don't,
I don't have
don't,
a log.
No.
He says, I don't have a log. Oh, I don't have a Yule log.
All right. There. Now, I'm going to wash my hands.
Log.
For a second.
All kids love logs.
Yeah, exactly.
Ooh, look at that.
All right.
It's like Play-Doh. Just like Play-Doh.
Just like, no, not just
Bam.
Like Play-Doh.
It's Play-Doh.
No.
All kids love log.
All right. I need a tray.
RCR, Happy New Year from Ireland. Cool.
Oh, happy. Oh, yeah, it's already New Year there.
Oh, yeah.
Isn't it?
No.
No,
five
not
hours,
yet.
Five
not
hours,
yet.
6 hours ahead.
Not yet. I know it is in Australia. It's the New Year.
Very cool.
All right, I'm going to go ahead and put the pecans, not that, on the tray.
All kids love log.
Yes, of course they do, honey. It's fun to play with.
What rolls downstairs, a loner in pairs, and over the neighbor's dog.
Oh, my goodness.
All
right.
It's
now,
it's
I'm
going to
very
log.
Carefully, very
it.
Carelessly, roll this
roll
onto
log.
The pecans. Stop it.
I'm giving you a play-by-play here.
I don't need a play-by-play.
It's a delicious.
This should be a ball, not a log. A ball would be easier.
Why not?
Because this is.
This is better for serving. Because then you can kind of just cut
okay.
off a piece.
Okay, fine. It's better for serving.
It is.
I'll take that. Fine.
I know it's harder to make it.
It is a little challenging, I'll be honest. Like I've said, I've never been good at rolling stuff like this.
You do very well with the bread.
Yeah, but that's different. That has structure to it. This just falls apart if you're not careful.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Now what?
I don't know.
Plate?
No, it's on a plate. I just need another one. Can you grab the other?
Make a giant C?
No.
Krista?
Here, grab that yellow plate. Please. Stinker.
I like that. Make it into a C.
No.
Why not?
Because you're a goof. All right.
You're going to roll it?
I'm going to just. There. There. It's done.
Log. There you go, folks.
We love log.
Enjoy your Texas cheese log.
Yeah.
A little messy there.
I mean, it is easy to do, but it's just a little. Maybe if we made them in smaller logs.
Yeah,
but
that probably would be
yeah.
a better idea.
Now, this one, cover with plastic.
Get it cool.
And put it in the refrigerator for at least 2 hours.
Okay.
So.
Alrighty there.
I'm going to go ahead and cover that with plastic. I wonder if I should roll it in plastic.
Old Glory Farm says, I'm a professional cheese log and cheese ball maker.
Oh.
I worked in a cheese factory making them.
Well, then you need to show me how.
Yeah, give us
the
secret.
Because I have no problem when it's, when I'm making, oh, come on.
Got it?
Yes. Just a little annoyed with the plastic wrap. When I'm making our fresh cheese, so the farmer's cheese, I have no problem doing that. This is just very soft.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Time to chill
so
it.
So this will go in the refrigerator for a couple hours.
And that'll be perfect time for when our friends come over.
Yep. If it lasts that long.
Cut a chunk and mail it to me, Sir Brad, says Faith and Family. Oh. I guess it would be okay if you put some like dry ice in there.
Oh yeah, sure.
Dry ice would do it.
Sure. That would work.
Scott's saying maybe balls instead of logs. Yeah, you could do that.
That's what I was thinking.
Smaller ones.
Yeah, smaller ones. That would be easier.
Yeah.
That's all right. Okay. So we've got about 2.5 minutes left on our...
Let me check it. Watch out, mama.
Okay.
Oh, not yet.
Not yet.
It's got another 5 minutes.
Okay.
Easy.
Okay. Well, then I'll change the timer to 5 minutes.
Yes.
Done. It did say 20 to 25 minutes. I put it in for 20.
Yeah, we definitely need the extra time.
Tomatoes. Lime juice.
Oh, it's time to switch gears to Pico.
I'm resetting.
Pico.
Resetting.
Now, just so you know, we know that about, scientifically, that about 50% of the population thinks cilantro tastes like soap, and they don't like it. You can omit the cilantro if you don't like it from this recipe, or if you're fortunate enough to know anybody who has papalo. Papalo has a similar flavor to cilantro, but people don't think it tastes like soap.
Right, right.
There's something about it that's just, okay.
It's really good. It's really good.
Papalo.
I need to drink water.
All right, let's see.
Now, in our recipe, it shows that you can use Roma tomatoes or large tomatoes and you dice them. Well, I have found I really like the grape tomatoes for the flavor way better.
They're a nice, bold, tomato-y flavor.
Yes.
That's true.
There's something about it. It gives just an awesome, it's really, really delicious.
And there's less of the I guess, what would you call it?
The seeds.
Yeah, like it's slime. I don't, what do you call it? There's a name
it's
for
the,
it.
It's the juice that's inside. There's more flesh with these.
Yes.
And if you had a fleshy tomato that was really bold in flavor, use
that.
Use whatever you want. I just find that I really like the grape tomatoes.
Well, you know what would be probably your perfect mix? Half that, and then when it's gardening season, what are those ones you like to...
Purple Cherokees.
Purple Russians.
Black Russians or purple Cherokees. Cherokees. Yeah. Those are my favorite.
Yeah. Hey, J.H. Is watching from Sweden.
Oh, hello.
Cool. BM says, I thought I was the only one who tasted soap and cilantro. No, they've done studies on it, and it's about half of people think that it's just gross.
Yeah. A lot of people don't like it.
Yeah.
It's going to take me a while to get these cut.
Old Glory Farm's giving you one of the tricks for the cheese log. Freeze it first for 10 minutes.
Oh,
before you start working it.
Oh, that's a great idea.
Well, she's a professional.
Yeah, she knows.
She is the log master.
Stop.
Sorry, I'll stop right there. She's the queen of log.
Yeah. Goodness gracious. You're so funny. So what I do with these grape tomatoes is I cut them in half, and then I cut them in quarters, and then I cut those. I don't know if you can, if you guys see what I'm doing. I cut that in. Depending on the size of it, I'll make three pieces out of that.
Yeah.
So it's a little bit smaller. These grape tomatoes are a little bit bigger than I normally use.
Which is nice.
Yeah.
Oh, we got somebody here who grows the purple Cherokees.
Oh,
Sandy grows them. We grow them too.
You can't grow them up here though. I tried this year and it didn't work.
Well, in Ohio we did.
Because the climate, they take longer to grow.
I wonder. I wonder if there's a way to heat the soil without having a hot house or a hoop house.
Yeah, I don't know.
I wonder if there's something I could invent to shove down into the ground.
I need to sharpen my knife.
I could figure this out.
This knife is dull city. No, I just need it sharpened. I prefer this knife. It's just dull city.
Okay. This is an interesting sharpener, guys. I don't know if you've seen these.
These are really neat.
They work pretty well.
Yeah.
You basically hold the knife on the counter. And we'll even show them.
Yeah.
But here, I'll go to the close cam so it's easier for you.
Okay.
There you go.
All right, so you put it on the counter with the blade up, and then you've got this guard here, so you're not cutting your fingers, and then you just run this along to sharpen it.
Just like that. Give it a few times.
I use this knife for just about everything. Dogs are flipping out for some reason.
Yeah, they're over there barking.
And then definitely rinse this off after you're done, because there's shards of metal on it.
Yeah, you don't want to put those in your cilantro.
Or anything.
Whoops. Hi. I'm going to have to go chastise the pooches, so I'll be right back.
Okay.
You'll hear me yelling out.
Well, that's way better.
You guys, knock it off!
Yeah.
Did you take a peek?
It's 5 minutes already. That went quick. Nope, not yet.
Not yet?
Not yet.
You guys, shush. Don't you know we're having a live stream?
Good dogs. They're really needy today.
Yeah, emotionally scarred animals.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And we didn't do anything.
No. No.
Somebody here, Grace? Okay.
I wonder if it's
this must
our
be
neighbor.
Next door.
Yeah. They probably heard a car door or something.
Yeah, I would imagine.
Yeah.
That sharpener is pretty cool, don't you think, guys?
Mm-hmm.
Here, I'll go back to the recipe screen so they can copy it down if they so desire. Yeah.
And usually when it's just us, I make just one of these packages of tomatoes. And so when I make the recipe, I'm only going to make it that way. But then later I'll add to it because we have company coming.
Mark. See, I don't know if it's Marcone. Is it Mark One or Marcone? I would guess Marcone.
I'd say Marcone.
From Nashville.
Okay.
I've spent a lot of time in Nashville. More a little south of there.
Yeah, yeah.
In the Sound Kitchen.
Mm-hmm. Is that still a place or did he sell it?
They sold it. I don't know if they still call it the Sound Kitchen. I believe they do.
The only thing I don't like about this cutting board is it's loud.
Yeah, you know, in the recording studio, the Sound Kitchen, just south of Nashville, they have, like, there's different studios all in one complex. And the big studio is called the Big Boy. And they have this massive gourmet kitchen, and they actually have one of the Frisch's Big Boy guys.
That's funny.
In it.
I thought that was named after Dino.
It was.
Oh.
He's a big boy. Yeah, I'll tell you what. Even if you're not interested in recording studios, go to the Sound Kitchen's website and look at it, because it's just really from cool. an architectural standpoint, it's beautiful.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. So let's see.
The rest of this goes faster. Sorry, guys. I didn't have time to cut the tomatoes beforehand.
Jalapenos, yummy.
Yeah.
All ready to go. Yeah.
Well, I got to chop those up, but that's okay.
Do we have the chopper thingy?
No. I use my knife. It's fine.
You're going to use a knife? Okay.
Yep. Almost done. Four more after this one.
Let me check this.
Okay.
Not yet. See, this oven, though, is kind of funny. Mm-hmm. It really doesn't brown the tops of things very well.
No.
It takes a lot longer than you think.
Yeah. It sure does.
Yeah. So, okay. Then we've gone over movies for New Year's.
Mm-hmm. Ow.
Is there anybody who's got a New Year's resolution? Now, I know that they say that most New Year's resolutions are gone by like the first week or so.
Yeah.
But is there anyone out there who's saying, you know what? I'm really going to do my best to stick to blah or change blah.
Right.
Because I know what I'm going to do. Mm-hmm. Honestly, I'm feeling a little more chubby than usual. We're gonna start changing some eating habits. And it's funny because our daughter Hope, she eats super healthy.
Mm-hmm.
And nobody asked her to. She just likes it.
Yeah.
And
she just wants to be healthy.
Yeah, so we're gonna try to, I guess, do a little bit better. Mm-hmm. You know, less butter, less this, less that, all that kind of stuff.
All right, so we need a diced onion. And this I do use a store-bought onion for. I do not use the Thrive onions for. I could, but this just has that crunch to it.
You gotta have it. So Delaney B is asking, is your cutting board glass? If so, they're hard on knife blades. And I thought that.
Ah, gotcha.
I thought that.
So it's more for decoration. Gotcha.
Jenny's making the New Year's resolution to stop falling downstairs.
Well, that's a good one. That's a really good one.
Marcone wants to be more positive. That's awesome. I need to finish the quilts for my grandkids and great nephew, says Kathy. Connie says, eat more homegrown food. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. Happy New Year's, Linda. Thank you. She says thank she you. Loves watching us.
Oh, thank you.
Try to read my words more. Or my word. I'm assuming God, the God's word. I'm assuming the Bible. My name is Hope, too. Oh. Well, hi, Hope.
Okay. I will not be using this cutting board on a live stream anymore.
No, it's loud.
It's too loud. I'm sorry.
There's one hip below you.
I know, but I'm almost done cutting.
Okay.
No, but you know what? I am going to grab it because I got to chop up the...
Max says, eating healthy is about quality and not less of this or that. I agree.
Yes.
I agree. And we grow a lot of our food, Max. Yes. Whether it's even the animals. We raise our own beef. Mm-hmm. We raise our own pork.
Yeah.
We raise our own chickens, eggs, milk. We're starting to make more cheeses from scratch.
I make our own yogurt.
Yeah, and it's delicious. Yep.
I found a new way to make yogurt, and I'm anxious to show everybody.
Is this a way I know?
No, actually. So you bring the milk up to temperature. The onions are really strong. And then I cool it down and add the yogurt starter to it. Nice. Then instead of it sitting in a pot and then I have to take it out, I put before it sits to culture or whatever, I put it in the jars. So that I don't have to do anything else to it except when it's done after 12 hours, I just put it in the refrigerator.
Yeah.
So it really worked out well last time.
Okay. Dan Schneider says he's going to increase to 50 hives.
Oh, wow.
You're a lunatic, bro. what in the world are you thinking?
No.
We love Dan, but 50 hives, that's a lot, bro.
That's a lot.
That's a lot.
Can you check this?
Yes, ma'am.
Check that.
Max, I'll come back to that. Not yet, believe it or not.
Well, it'll be done when we're done with this.
Yeah, I guess so.
Oh,
sorry. Max says he wants to, where was it? Oh, I missed it. I've lost it. Sorry, Max. I'll try to find it again.
Mix this up.
Darlene is cleaning out her craft stash. Linda is wanting to downsize photo albums. Cool. Reading the Bible more, Delaney B. That's awesome. Faith and family, more intentional about my faith. Awesome. I make resolutions not to make resolutions, says Scott.
I'm right there with you.
Yeah. Yep. Happy New Year, Max. Thank you.
All right, we need some jalapenos. And you can use fresh jalapenos. We prefer the pickled jalapenos.
Yeah.
It has a different flavor, the vinegar vibe. Yeah, so I don't touch them with my hands because I have learned that if you touch them with your hands, then you automatically rub your eyes. Don't know why that is.
It's just a thing.
A thing.
Hey, you know what? This is interesting here, Mom. BM Dwell says the K2 and grass-fed butter eats up plaque and arteries. I knew that. We've been having a
K2 or A2?
K2.
What's K2?
It's one of the...
vitamins?
Yes.
Oh.
Yes.
Okay.
But we've been having that conversation with Jeff.
Yeah.
From JLR Valley, their store there.
Yeah.
And he was mentioning that same exact thing.
Funny.
And we happen to have a cow that's high in K2.
Yeah. I've never heard I didn't know what K2 was.
Yeah. True. Oh, okay. Let's see.
That was a conversation they had when I was not listening.
Yes.
Okay. And of course I touched it.
Now you're going to touch
your eyes. I'm going to touch my eyes, which is always the case.
Yeah.
All right. So the jalapenos, it's all in your flavor. You want it hotter, add more. You don't, add less or none at all.
Yep.
That is all up to you.
Smoky, put some poblano in there.
Yep. Or you can add some of the chipotle seasoning.
Mm-hmm.
It's entirely up to you. That's the beautiful part of pico de gallo. You can make it how you want it.
Yeah.
Now, there's just a few more things. I need more garlic. Darn it.
Holy mackerel.
Yeah.
We have more.
Thankfully. We usually have two or three of these in the refrigerator at one time.
Yeah, our cow, BM says, lucky. Mm-hmm. Our cow, Dottie, is super high in K2.
Yeah.
Yeah, her milk fat is really high, too. Yeah. Matter of fact, it's kind of cool. The people that are coming over tonight, one of their kids has a dietary issue and has to really be careful with sugar. So I made some ice cream fresh for her, just cream and the pure stevia. It's a sweetener. There's no sugar. Diabetics can have it and it doesn't affect them in any way. And it tastes super sweet. So that and cocoa powder. And that's it.
That's it.
Oh, I should have put a pinch of salt in there, just a little bit.
That's all right.
But yeah, I'm excited to see how that goes because making ice cream from straight up cream from our cow.
Oh, it's so good. So good.
Let me tell you what.
All right, so I added in the jalapenos, I added in the garlic and the salt. And again, salt, it's however much you like. If you like it a little saltier, add more. It's entirely up to you. And the same with the garlic. A little bit of lime juice.
HR, when are we eating? We'll be right over. Come on over, man. I'm assuming you're a man. I don't know if you're a man. You could be a woman.
That's so true.
Sorry. Come on over.
Come on over. Okay, so I went to the grocery store this morning, and the local grocery store did not have any cilantro. So I am using our Thrive cilantro, which is freeze-dried, and it is actually really good.
The flavor is nice and intense.
Oop. Nope, we don't want that. So... And it's, again, preference in all what you want. And that's it.
But now, here's the trick. You got to let it sit.
Yeah, you got to make this the day before, if possible.
Oh, my gosh.
Or morning before. It's, so good. I mean, you can eat it now. It's good now.
But don't.
Because those flavors have to just kind of marry together. And
yeah.
Ooh, so yummy.
Stevia, the tiniest bit with monk fruit. Oh yeah, here. Well, hold, do you want me to hold it up?
Okay.
Oh, wrong camera. Yeah. That's okay. I'll go to that. I'll go to you.
Hold on.
3, 2, 1. Blast off. Look at that. Colorful.
Out of focus.
Yeah, that camera's wonky. But yeah. So. Okay.
Super colorful. The color doesn't do any justice on the camera, but it's super bright. And if you have fresh cilantro, it's even brighter. It just looks like Christmas. I love it.
Are you ready?
Yep.
Hot pots. Oh, I can smell it.
I can't smell it.
I can finally smell it.
My nose is scarred by onions, so.
Oh, this is going to be good, folks.
Oh, yeah.
Looky, looky.
Looky, looky.
Oh, my gracious. See the bubbling?
Yeah.
Now, how are we going to do this to show them? Just a spoon?
Just a spoon.
And I happen to have a cracker at the ready.
Oh my goodness gracious.
I'll get the crackers. You get a spoon.
Yeah.
We need a plate too, or else.
Yes, we do.
Yeah, that could be detrimental to one's health.
Maybe.
Oh my gosh, people. That I wish you could smell this.
So creamy.
Look at that. Oh my gracious. Woohoo!
It's gonna be really hot.
I know, I'm going to wait, but I want to show.
Yeah.
Let's see. Can we get it any closer?
And it didn't spill over. I'm really happy about that.
So it's cheesy. You've got the sauerkraut, the corned beef, and here we go. Oops. I should probably.
Careful. That pan's hot.
I know. Let's just try to go like that. Here you go, Mama.
Oh, thank you, dear.
That's for you. I'll get one for me. Let's see. See?
Mm-hmm.
Whoops, that way.
I can taste the tang of the pickle and the sauerkraut.
Oh my gosh, guys, that's so good.
Mm.
I know what I'm having for lunch.
Mm-hmm.
No, we gotta save it for the party.
Right. That's all you get.
That's all you get?
That's all you get.
Oh my gracious.
It is so good. And you guys saw how easy that was.
Yeah, it didn't even take 5 minutes.
No, to throw that all together is super, super easy. The hardest part was mixing it because I don't want to use the mixer and mess up all the pieces of beef.
Yeah, you don't want to.
You probably could do it in the KitchenAid. That beater won't beat the stew out of it.
And believe it or not, there's very little sauerkraut taste.
Mm-hmm. You can taste a little bit of it.
It's more the texture in the bite.
Right.
I don't know what happened to it, but it's very little tart. Mm-hmm. Not that bad.
Yeah. And it's still got, it's still juicy from the sauerkraut. Show. Yeah, see, look it. But not a lot.
Barely.
Yeah, it's barely.
And as you let it sit out, it'll probably solid
up even
more.
It'll solid up, yeah.
Yeah.
So yummy.
There it is, folks.
Thank you, Alyssa, if you're watching.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
That will do.
High five. That bite was awesome. Mm.
Oh, yeah.
I've had it. I'm sorry.
You were getting all excited.
I've not made it until today, but I've had it before, mm-hmm. and it was so good then. Oh, but it's way better right out of the oven.
Oh, my gosh.
We'll have to put it back in the oven before they get here. Yeah,
just warm it up. Maybe hit it with some tin foil for now.
Maybe. Mm-hmm.
Mm. Well, you guys.
Yeah.
I hope you have an amazing new year.
Yes.
And you know what? Side note. I noticed some of you guys were saying that you wanted to get more serious about your faith. Mm-hmm. We do a Monday through Friday Bible devotion on a different channel. Mm-hmm. It's called Big Family Devotions. And that's 8:30 in the morning.
Central.
Mm-hmm. So we keep it pretty low key. There's no arguing. There's no yelling about scriptures. None of that.
No.
So if you want, it's 8:30, mm-hmm. Big Family Devotions.
And we don't talk about religions and what, in comparison to religions, but Brad is talking straight scripture.
Yeah, we read the Bible and then we just unpack it. Mm-hmm. That's all it is. Yeah. And then we pray.
Yep.
So anyway, you're invited if you want to come.
It's a double dog dare.
Double dog dare.
Oh, no, triple dog dare.
Whoa.
Right.
So anyway,
yep.
That's it. Hope you guys have an awesome New Year's, mm-hmm. and blessings.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye.